Good evening, listeners. It's Owl Stretching Time. And now, here's your host, Frank Macaluso.
Thank you, Jordan. Hello, everybody, and thank you for tuning in once again to Owl Stretching Time. You've caught us at quite an interesting time. You see, I just received a package from my aunt and uncle back in Chicago, but it was really, really big, so I had to have Antonio and Michael and Emily help me carry it. Now we're going to open it and see what's inside.
I hope it's snacks. I could really go for some chips right now.
I think that's a little too heavy to be just snacks. It's probably a sculpture or something.
Why would his aunt and uncle send him a sculpture?
I don't know. It might spruce up his living room.
It could also be one of those shelf thingies you have to build yourself.
Yeah. That makes a lot more sense.
Well, there's only one way to find out. It's a robot.
Let's see what it does.
Greetings. I am Scriptobot 3000. I am programmed to assist in the creative process.
The heck?
Hey, I've heard of these things. I hear they have a few of them on the writing staff of Grey's Anatomy.
That's still on?
Yeah, but it's gotten kind of bad.
That's not a comforting thought.
Well, maybe it does better with comedy.
Maybe. Their formulas to good comedy. Robots are good with formulas, but at the same time, I don't think robots can have much of a sense of humor.
You could program one into it.
I guess, but does this robot have one programmed into it?
Let's find out. Hey, Scriptobot, can you write comic sketches designed for radio?
This unit is unaccustomed to writing sketch comedy, but can adapt to fulfill any of your program's needs.
Neat!
I don't know about this. Sketches written by robots. Doesn't seem right. Comedy requires soul and empathy.
He's right, Emily. Maybe having a robot write sketches for the show isn't a good idea.
Frank, last semester you had a stress-induced heart attack in the middle of an episode. If having this robot write sketches for you means that never happens again, I think that's a step worth taking.
Well, yeah, but...
She's right, Frank. And besides, it would give you more time to focus on schoolwork.
You guys aren't going to give up until I agree, are you?
Nope.
All right, let's do it.
Great. Scriptobot, go into sketch comedy mode.
As you wish. Now operating in sketch comedy mode. Hi, Floor. I love you.
This does not bode well.
We better get on with the show now. We've been standing here yammering for like 5 minutes.
Right. What's the first sketch?
It's the restaurant one.
Thanks. For our first sketch of the evening, we examine an instance of a young man taking his girlfriend to a fancy restaurant to meet his family.
When's Chad gonna get here?
Should be here pretty soon, sweetie. He said to be here at 6. He's got 4 minutes.
I can't wait to finally meet his new girlfriend. He's talked so much about her.
Hey, guys.
Chad, how are you?
I'm okay. Guys, this is Susie, the love of my life. Susie, this is my dad.
Hi, you can call me Len.
Hi, nice to meet you.
That's my sister Hope.
Hi.
Hi.
And that's my sister Izzy.
How do you do?
I'm pretty good. How are you?
Pretty excited, not gonna lie. It's so nice to finally meet you.
Likewise. Say, honey, where's your mom? I know you've only mentioned her a couple of times, but she sounded really cool.
I guess he didn't tell you. Our mom actually passed away last year.
Oh. Oh, God, I am so sorry.
No, I didn't mean to.
It's fine.
It's fine. It's my fault. I should have told you.
Well, if it isn't too much trouble, do you think you could tell me a little bit more about her?
Sure. Hit it.
What's going on?
Ooh,
She was born in New Orleans, New Orleans, Louisiana. Branded with the name Lisa Sawyer, circa 1963. Grandmother was Indian. Her mother's name was Bertha, swift as the wind, fierce as fire. Her father's name was Victor. Worked two jobs to provide for his flock.
Okay, literally none of that is true. Our mother's name was Angelina, and she was like 100% Italian.
Yeah, and she was from Forsyth.
She was the youngest of seven. She grew up on Louisa Street, chaos around. But inside, cozy, small, but I mention in her eyes.
Chad, your mother was an only child, and you know that.
Also, where did those backing singers come from? Was this, like, planned?
Ooh, never had much money. But was filthy rich, by the wealth he couldn't get from a dark casino, a lottery ticket. They had a love, rich in love.
Her parents divorced when she was three, and her mother beat her like a rug.
Oh my God.
At the age of 16, she found Christ at an altar. All along he was calling her name. The gospel spoken from an old wrinkled May, God spoke.
Okay, that's it. Stop the music. Stop it.
Dad, what are you doing?
Backup singers, you can go home or back to your meal or whatever.
Dad!
This whole thing stops now, Chad. Look, I know you're still not quite over getting kicked out of that little band you were in.
The band I founded.
And I know you're still grieving for your mother, but that's no reason for what just happened here. Now let's just sit down and have a nice, normal, honest conversation. No singing, just words.
Okay.
I'm sorry about that, Susie. He can be a bit of a handful sometimes.
Oh, I'm very aware of that fact.
So, how did you two meet?
Well, we...
Oh, honey, let me tell it.
I was born a liver.
No, stop that right now.
No.
Enough. No. More.
And now for...
Hi.
And now...
I wrote a sketch thingy.
That's nice, Scriptobot. And now
Aren't you going to use it in the show?
Well, we can't really do it right now, but we... All right! We'll do the sketch!
You play the host person. I'll get the others.
Okay, then. And now for a sketch written by a robot.
It's time now for Dysfunctional Family Quiz Time! And now, here's your host, Kenny Day!
Thank you, Johnny. Thank you, folks, and welcome to Dysfunctional Family Quiz Time. Well, since our announcer thought it prudent not to introduce our contestants, I suppose I'll have to do it myself, just like I have to do everything around here. Our contestants this evening are my lovely wife, Jacqueline, my eldest son and captain of the football team, Derek, and my youngest, worthless, no-good son, Jacob.
Honey, could you please
stay out of this? Hey, Jacob, How does it feel to be a complete and total failure?
Shut up, Dad.
Don't you talk to me like that! We have company! Let's get this game rolling, shall we? Our categories are unacceptable grades, music genres that are crap and not allowed in the house, people who are pathetic, why Aunt Cheryl isn't welcome at Christmas anymore, and the Beach Boys. Derek, since you helped your team win the championship for the second year in a row, you pick the first category.
Okay, Dad, I'll go with music genres that are crap and not allowed in the house for 200.
Don't encourage him, Derek.
I'm sorry, Jacob. Was anyone talking to you? I thought not. All right. Music genres that are crap and not allowed in the house for 200. This genre of music is the sound of death, corruption, and the rage of hell unleashed upon the earth. Yes, Derek?
What is punk rock?
That is absolutely correct, Derek. Pick the next category.
I'll pick music genres that are crap and not allowed in the house for 400.
This genre of music is the music of drunken, inbred hicks who contribute nothing to society and ought to be euthanized and taken out of the gene pool. Yes, Jackie?
What is country music?
That's correct. Pick the next category.
This is ridiculous. Mom, why are you letting him do this?
Jacob, you speak out of turn just once more, and I swear I will stop paying your college tuition. How's that make you feel, huh? You feel like interrupting again now, huh?
Let's just keep playing the game, honey. Please?
All right. Derek, pick the next category.
But, honey, I thought I was supposed to pick the next category.
I changed my mind. A man's allowed to change his mind, isn't he? I mean, this is America, right? We are here in America, aren't we?
Sorry, I just thought
Don't
that...
Don't think, okay? I'll do the thinking. You just worry about getting dinner done on time.
Okay, honey.
Mom, seriously!
Were you saying something, Jacob?
No, sir.
All right, then. Derek, pick the next category.
Okay, I'll pick people who are pathetic for 400.
Really? That's what you want?
Yes, Dad.
Well, it's your life. Throw it away if you want. See if I care.
I could pick a different category if you want.
No, no. Well, you pick the one you wanted. We'll stick with that. People who are pathetic for 400. This person doesn't have the testicular fortitude to admit that I was right about his lack of any discernible acting skill.
Oh, come on!
How come you didn't get into NYU then? Huh, Jacob? Tell me how come. You were a rotten actor in kindergarten and you're a rotten actor now!
Shut up, Dad!
I get you wanting to be an actor, though. You get paid to stand on a stage and lie. You're very good at that.
Is that really any different from what you do for a living?
Being a lawyer is real work! You disgusting little crap. I actually contribute to society, not like you, you pathetic little weasel. If you weren't my own flesh and blood, I'd have killed you eons ago, done the whole world a favor.
You know, Dad, it's funny you should say that.
Honey, put that gun down before someone gets hurt.
Oh, calm down, Jackie. He's not going to do anything. He hasn't got the grapes.
Honey, don't.
If he really wants to kill me, let him try. Come on, Jacob. Pull the trigger. Kill your old man. Do it, you worm. Do it. Go on. You want to kill me? Do it. Do it in front of all these people. Show them you're a big man. Go on. Do it. Do it!
Damn it. I can't. Why can't I do it? I hate you.
Here, give me that. I'll do it.
Derek, what are you...
WJMU would like to apologize for the dark nature of the previous sketch. It is not WJMU's policy to depress or traumatize its audience, and steps are now being taken to ensure such an occurrence does not happen again. Here now, in an attempt to restore your mental well-being, is a sketch that is incredibly silly.
It's time now for Live Studio Audience! Live Studio Audience is filmed in front of a live studio audience.
I'm excited to see this new show, Carrie.
Me too. I'm not entirely sure what it's all about. I mean, a show called Live Studio Audience. What do you think it's about?
I don't know. Maybe it's about a couple of people who sit in the studio audience of a bunch of TV shows.
Well, that sounds boring. What was that?
Carrie? You might want to look out there.
Oh my god! It's a studio audience. Like, another studio audience. I guess you were right.
Is it too late to get a refund on our tickets?
Let's just sit down.
Okay.
This isn't right.
Yeah, why are we watching a studio audience?
I think they're watching us.
Why?
I don't know, but it's weirding me out.
Oh, excuse me. Pardon me. Excuse me. Pardon me.
Excuse me.
Pardon me.
What was that all about?
I don't know. Maybe he's, like, a popular recurring character?
Maybe he's the main character.
We'd better shut up then. He might say something funny.
He's not saying anything.
Don't worry. He might say something later. Maybe he's just thinking.
No one is talking here except you and me. What sort of place is this?
Calm down, Carrie. This is a television studio. They film television shows here. Nothing bad is going to happen to us.
There's no sets, Julia. No sets. There is no show. Maybe they gathered us all here to kill us.
Pull yourself together, woman.
Ow! You hit me.
I'm sorry.
Why the hell would you do that?
You were getting hysterical.
I'm not hysterical. I'm scared.
Excuse me. Excuse me, ladies, but I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you two to leave.
What? Why?
You're disturbing the other members of the audience. Now come along.
Well, okay. Come on, Carrie.
Okay.
Aww. Hey, look! It's starting!
It's time now for Live Studio Audience! Live Studio Audience is filmed in front of a live studio audience.
I'm excited to see this new show, Chrissy.
Me too. I'm not exactly sure what it's all about. I mean, a show called Live Studio Audience? What do you think it's about?
I don't know. Maybe it's about a couple of people who sit in the studio audiences of a bunch of TV shows.
Well, that sounds boring. What was that?
Chrissy? You might want to look out there.
Oh my God.
If you wish to complain about the lack of a proper ending to this sketch, here's the address to write to.
1379 South Evergreen Terrace, Left Noob, Saskatchewan, 60694.
Here's that address again.
2525 Northeast Huguenot Walloon Drive, Bald Knob, Arkansas, 41144.
Thank you for your patronage.
We will now pause for...
I'm hungry! Write me a poem!
What? No!
Please! I'll be your bestest friend in the whole world!
Emily, you're an English major. Write Scriptobot a poem.
Why?
Just do it!
What kind of poem do you want?
I want a poem with a lot of killings and a lot of murders in it so I can sleep real good.
Yikes.
We will now pause for station identification, followed by a brief message from one of our sponsors.
Sing me, sing me, sing me. Sing me, sing me, baby.
You're listening to WJMU 89.5, The Quad.
I know what you're thinking. Did he fire 6 shots or only 5? Well, to tell you the truth, in all this excitement, I kind of lost track myself. But being that this is a 44 Magnum, the most powerful handgun in the world, and to blow your head clean off, you got to ask yourself one question.
What are those?
Seriously? That meme died out like 2 years ago.
Glamour punk! Oh. Right.
Don't get caught with last year's cheap knockoffs. Get today's hottest brands at discount prices at Stanley's Shoe and Boot Emporium, located at the corner of Main and Main in downtown Decatur.
And we're back. And now for-
I'm gonna go bag me a bunny rabbit!
You go do that, Scriptobot.
Kill the rabbit! Kill the rabbit! Kill the rabbit!
You know, Frank, I'm beginning to think activating Scriptobot was a bad idea.
I'd say I told you so, but even I couldn't have predicted a dumpster fire of this magnitude. You know, thanks to her, we're running behind now. We're gonna have to cut the carpet fitters of the Old West sketch.
Aw, man. Antonio is finally gonna get a chance to do that Enrico Caruso impression he's been working on.
Yeah, well, now we have to skip to our final sketch. Hit it, Jordan.
And now, Pointless Filler Theater proudly presents... The Kirkwoods! Our drama begins in the Westview Funeral Parlor in affluent uptown Decatur.
Thank you for coming, Miss Dorothy.
We're all gonna miss your mother terribly, Curtis. She was a good, kind-hearted woman, and we all loved her very much.
Thank you, Miss Dorothy.
And I'm sure she would have loved this wake you organized for her. Well, aside from the whole being dead thing.
Thank you very much, Miss Dorothy.
All right now, I'm gonna go over and talk to your sister. If you ever need anything, let me know.
I will, Miss Dorothy. Thank you.
How you holding up, Curtis?
I'm doing okay, Dale.
You really did good with planning this, and you got all the family out here.
Not all of them.
Well, you know, Scott, he's eccentric.
He's a selfish bastard who doesn't care about any of us.
I don't say that, Curtis.
Why not? It's true. He couldn't even be bothered to attend his own mother's wake.
Whoa, calm down there, Curtis. You worked too hard on planning this wake to ruin it by making a scene. Look, you're probably just hangry. You haven't had breakfast yet. Why don't you go over to the snack buffet and have some biscotti and some coffee or something, okay?
I guess I am a little hungry.
There we go. That's a good boy.
Hello, Dale. I'm so sorry about your mother. She was a very good woman.
Thank you. Quick reminder, who are you exactly?
You don't remember me?
I can't say that I do. I'm sorry.
Don't you remember when we were little, at Uncle David's birthday party? We played Uno together with Cousin Lou and Cousin Abigail.
I remember Lou and Abigail.
Then you surely must remember me.
I'm afraid not. I mean, I don't doubt that you were there. I just can't recall your name.
Hey, Dale. Sorry to hear
Buzz
about-
Buzz off, Twiggy. We're catching up.
Meanwhile, in a small apartment in Chicago.
Just a minute.
Hey, Scott. Put on some pants. We've got a gig.
I thought I told you I was out of the business.
You're never out of the business, just on hiatus. Come on.
I don't know, man. I don't know if I have it in me anymore.
A guy as talented as you can't ever lose it. Now come on, Myrna does not like to be kept waiting.
Wait, Myrna? Myrna Wood? The Myrna Wood. You got us a recording gig with the Myrna Wood.
You bet your sweet ass I did. Now seriously, dude. Put on some pants.
Meanwhile, back at the funeral parlor.
Still upset over Scott, huh?
How could you tell?
That's your 15th cup of coffee today.
18, but who's counting?
Look, he's a successful musician. He probably had a gig he couldn't cancel.
He never got back to me. I sent him texts and emails, I left voice messages, nothing. He wants nothing to do with us. Remember how you found out he joined a band?
I came across a poster while visiting a friend in Chicago.
Exactly. He never would have told us about it if we hadn't found out for ourselves.
That doesn't mean he doesn't care about us.
He never visited Mom when she was in the hospital. Not even a phone call. He could have at least let us know if he was busy. Face it, Maisie. Scott doesn't care about us.
Crystal?
No.
Rachel?
No.
Erica?
No! I was the short one, remember? I kept talking about my new cat.
Mr. Whiskers.
You remember my cat's name after all those years, but you can't remember mine?
Well, that's a cat. Cats are adorable.
I'm adorable, too.
Excuse me, miss, but could
Take
you-
Take a hike, bozo. I'm gonna get you to remember my name if it kills you, Dale Kirkwood.
Meanwhile, in a recording studio in Evanston.
I really don't think I can do this. I mean, this is Myrna frickin' Wood.
Would you quit psyching yourself out, man? You're the best tambourine player in Chicagoland. You've got this. Now let's go in there and rock out.
Hey, man. I couldn't help but overhear you having some confidence issues. I got something that could help you.
Look, man, I'm not interested in anything like that.
I understand that. Hey, look at that.
What? Where? What am I supposed to be looking at?
Poop with a syringe!
Ow!
So long, sucker.
5 minutes later.
La 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 la, give me some love. Give me some love. Give me some love.
Stop, stop, stop. Johnny, I thought you said he was the best tambourine player in Chicagoland.
He is, really, Miss Wood.
He's nothing but a junkie. I've had it. This session is over and you are all fired. I'll see to it you never work in this town again.
Shut up, you uptight bitch.
Did you just call me a bitch?
I sure as hell did, Miss Myrna Wood. What are you gonna do about it?
Meanwhile, back at the funeral parlor.
Ariane?
No!
Anais?
No!
Megan, Kaylani, Melissa, just tell me already!
No! I want you to remember!
Hello? Well, 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 if it isn't Mr. Big Shot Tambourine Man, to what do I owe the pleasure of finally being blessed with your voice? Of course, you need something. No, yeah, I'll be there. Goodbye. I have to go.
What's wrong?
Scott's in jail. Apparently, insulting a local pop legend is an arrestable offense in Evanston.
Oh my god.
5 hours later.
Curtis! You came!
Yeah, well, don't get your hopes too high. I've done a lot of thinking on the long, long ride over here. You missed our mother's wake. You basically cut me and Maisie and everyone out of your life.
I didn't
Why didn't you tell us about your band, Scott? Why didn't you even call Mom when she was sick? You could have at least answered my voicemail or one of my emails or texts and let us know that you couldn't make it. I'm not bailing you out. You can rot in here for all I care. Goodbye, Scott. Goodbye forever.
Wait! Curtis! Come back! Curtis!
Is that really how this plotline ends? Someone hand me a script.
Here you go.
Thank you. Enter Curtis. Curtis tells Scott to go screw himself. Who wrote this garbage?
I did. Hi, I'm a writer. Ow, ow, you're kicking me. Why are you kicking me? What did I do to you? Ow, my nose, my beautiful nose. Why? Ah, my pancreas. I need those things. Stop kicking my pancreas. Ow, my stomach. Ow, my ribcage. Ow, my naughty bits. Why do you keep repeatedly kicking me? Will nothing satisfy your bloodlust? Ow, my kneecap. You've shattered my patella. Isn't this a little excessive? Please stop kicking me. I have a wife and 3 children and student loans. Please stop kicking me. Ah, my brain piece. I'm unconscious. How can I work if I'm unconscious? You're a really bad friend.
Meanwhile, back at the funeral parlor.
Look, lady, the funeral ended 17 hours ago. Would you let me go, please?
Not until you get my name right. I'll keep you here 17 years if that's what it takes.
Allison?
No.
Lindsay?
No.
Genevieve?
That's exactly right.
Oh, finally. Now, how do we end this sketch?
Well, we could take a page out of the Muppet Playbook. When you can't think of a good ending, you just blow everything up.
Did somebody say blow up?
Wait, I didn't mean literally. I just meant to...
Oh my god! Is everyone okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
The studio's completely destroyed! Scriptobot! Why the hell would you do that?
I thought it'd be funny.
Where did you even get those explosives anyway?
From my new bestest friend! Come on in, bestest friend!
Exterminate! Exterminate!
Ain't he just the ginchiest?
Oh my god. And with that, we come to the end of our show for tonight. I'd like to thank you all for tuning in, and we hope to be with you all again same time next week. Until then, good night, and be safe.
That was Owl Stretching Time, starring Frank Macaluso, Will Barden, Emily Bowes, Michael Santos, and Antonio Verdera, with Mackenzie Barnett, Emilio Canals, Jordan Garrison, Josie Hand, Mo Mollering, and Ben Woodcock. This episode was written by Frank Macaluso and Ruth Zilke, and directed and produced by Frank Macaluso. The song Lisa Sawyer was written by Leon Bridges, Austin Jenkins, Joshua Block, and Chris Vivian, and was originally performed by Leon Bridges. This is your announcer, Jordan Comish, speaking.